It is Walk 97.5 with Christina Kay and Cameron Mathison. I feel like we're off to a good start, Cameron. We almost have like matching sweaters going on, matching vibes in the background. I'm digging this.
I said I would only do like this interview if like everything was jiving. You know what I mean? I wanted Christmas decorations behind you. I got Christmas decorations behind me. I said we got to be in the same color palette. And thankfully it's happening. So that's great.
And it was like all on a mental note too. We didn't have an
No,
email or a text exchange going on. We just knew.
I mean, listen, but Christmas does that, don't you think? Like Christmas
Yeah.
definitely like, gets everybody in the same kind of mind frame. It's that magical time of year.
I was
And
gonna say, there's definitely magic when you think of the holiday season and the movies that it brings and the music and the whole vibes. And this is proof right here, Exhibit A.
yep, true, true.
So before we talk about the holidays, Cameron, I just want to say to you, I remember, oh God, this was a long time ago. You were on GMA and you did something where you were in Cars Land. I don't know if you were opening Disney California Adventure or Cars Land, and I'm a Disney nut, and I remember watching it and I was like, I want to do something like that. I want to open lands. And I'm 20 years into my career now and I have gotten to open so many things with Disney, but you were the inspiration for that because I didn't even know that was a
Wow.
thing. I'm gonna like start crying over here talking
That
about
is
it.
so cool. I love that. That's so, and it was like I definitely was there for the opening of a California Adventure, and then I was there. But what you're talking about was the official launch of Cars
Cars
Land.
Land. Yeah.
Yeah. So it's when I rode with the actor who plays who voices Mater,
Oh, Larry the Cable Guy.
Larry the Cable Guy of the cable. And then I was on, we did the ride, and that was all live, and we did all these different rides, and some of them have actually changed since then.
Yeah.
They've updated and changed them. But yeah, that was, I remember that because I had my kids there. It was the
Yeah.
middle of the night, basically,
Yeah.
because it
The
had
East
to be like,
Coast.
I think it was the 8 o'clock hour for New York time. So it was the 5 o'clock hour West Coast. So it was crazy.
And I just remember that opened up a whole new world for me. So I always said, like, I always kind of felt connected to you in a way. And I mean, look at this today. It's still a thing.
You see what happened? We've connected on a heart level, on a Christmas heart level.
Yes, the
That's
magic of
awesome.
Disney, the magic of Christmas. And I have always loved all of your holiday films too. They just brought so much joy into me and my family's life. So thank you for all of
I appreciate
that.
you saying that. Thanks. Yeah, I love making them, that's for sure.
And you must love Christmas. I mean, I see the decorating already.
Oh,
So
I mean, I don't even talk, this just happened. I just have to like, I mean, it just kind of pops up. No, I do. I love, love, love. I mean, so many of us. I think that's why these movies and why Great American Family is just sort of touching the hearts of so many people, and this festival that we're going to be talking about. It's just that like I love Christmas. People love Christmas. It's a magical time of year. It brings people together. It touches us in our heart in ways that that I don't think get we get moved in any other way. And there's
Totally.
just the magic about it, and the traditions, and
Yes.
like I'm starting now, which is a little bit late, to like start my lighting outside. Like that's a whole thing. Let me tell you something, it's going to take me
Yeah.
a while. I wrap this 50-foot tree and all its branches in front of my house. I do it myself because nobody kind of like does it the way I like,
Understands
and
the way you do
I
it,
have the
yeah.
technique down. But I climb this tree like I'm up in the tree and the branches out, and I have a backpack full of the
Oh my
lights
gosh.
wrapped in a ball, and wrap and then tie it and do the next one right out on the branch. And then I come back and I do the other branch and the other, and this tree just lights up the whole neighborhood. I'm telling you,
You
it
have
goes
your own
above my,
Rockefeller Center Christmas tree over there.
it's sort of like that, but it's more like the ones where you kind of wrap all the branches so the whole thing
Okay.
really,
Oh,
really, really brightens up. Yeah, pretty
that's
cool.
awesome. We always say, like, when we're watching the Christmas movies, we want to like live in these movies. It sounds like you kind of are already. Like, I mean, I know you film these movies probably like in summertime, right? So
Sometimes.
you're like just Christmas all year round, and I love that that magic doesn't go away for you.
Yeah, you sometimes you film in the summertime, and so that you're like accessing the, because making these movies for a large part, like you're walking into these beautiful sets, you're walking into the houses that are decorated the way you want your house to be decorated. I literally go to these movies, I come out with like decoration tips, and like cookie tips, and like all of it, all gift giving.
Yeah.
Sentimental things, and they're like, man, I should be more like my character. He's pretty good. Yeah, so it's true. Like, to your point, we get little, obviously there's Christmas in July, which we celebrate, Great American
Of
Family,
course.
but in general, like when we're shooting these movies, like we shot this one in August and September, And so it was starting to get a little cold. We shot it up on an island off the coast of Western Canada. And so it was nice because we got to wear the Christmas stuff and not be like, super, super hot. But sometimes it could be June, July, and then it's a little bit trickier. But at the same time, it doesn't affect the magic of Christmas, like making the movie and feeling Christmas always is always nice. Doesn't matter what time of year.
I love that. But this time of year, I love that we're now going to be able to almost step into the world with the Great American Christmas Festival that you're going to be at opening weekend at UBS Arena. Cameron, I'm so excited about this. I've always
Yeah,
wanted
me
to
too.
be in a movie like that.
Yeah, that's really our goal with this, and I'm thrilled to be at the opening weekend. So everybody, it starts November 22nd at UBS, like you said. And this is going to be also, like you said, a very immersive Christmas experience where you almost feel like you're in one of the Great American Family Christmas movies, in the sense that, you're going to have some of the actors there for sure hanging out. It's going to be very, very relatable. Like, we're all going to be kind of in it together. There's going to be gourmet food, and there's going to be drinks, and there's going to be ice skating, and there's going to be a Christmas tree lighting, I think,
Every night, right?
every night. Yeah, that's right. And then screenings of the movies, like first time seen for a lot of these movies. Home Sweet Christmas that I
Yes,
did
the new
with
one.
Candace Cameron Bure, which is coming out. And then we're going to have some of the Islanders there, and it's just going to be a really, really cool immersive Christmas experience. Caroling, did I mention caroling?
I didn't know this.
There's going to be, I think there's going to
Oh my
be,
gosh, you're really in the
we call it
movies.
a karaoke. There's going to be some karaoke-ing.
I'm so into that.
Yeah,
S
I think
sign me
that's,
up.
yeah, that's not my specialty, but I dive in. Like,
What would be your go-to Christmas song for Christmas karaoke?
that's a really good question. I would have to say something like fun and upbeat. I would say something like Feliz Navidad, or like,
Yes, crowd favorite. So that everyone else
I
can
think
join
those
in.
for the karaoke, I would want it more upbeat and not some of the, like, I've
No
got some
Christmas shoes.
more sentimental ones that, like my mom used to love and things like that. But I think for, I'd go for the more upbeat, rocking around the Christmas tree. I don't know,
Those are
things,
all great.
Jingle Bell Rock, things like that, just to kind of keep it upbeat and lively so everybody's out there dancing.
I love that. It's great with Feliz Navidad too, because you can just do the mic to the crowd and everyone else joins in. So
Exactly, right? And it's like, what is it, like six words? Like, we all know the words. You know what I mean? That's why probably I love it, because I can't mess anything up.
exactly. I'm so excited that you and Candace Cameron Bure are finally in a holiday movie together. How have we not had this already? You guys are holiday royalty.
It's funny because we've talked about it for over a decade. I don't even know how long. I've known her for a long time, obviously being in the same Christmas movie kind of like families through the year, but also when I was working Good Morning America and then Entertainment Tonight, I've interviewed her. I mean, we were trying to figure it out. I probably interviewed her five or six times through the years with her promoting different things. And she was on Dancing with the Stars after I was on Dancing with the Stars. And when she was on that, I was covering the show. And she used, before they announced the cast, we get code names. And she used my name as a code name for her
Oh my
because I've been
gosh.
so, like, we just had this, like, constantly kind of like coming close, coming close, coming close. And then boom, it finally happened. And I think it was worth the wait. Home Sweet Christmas is the movie. It's premiering December 1st, 8 p.m. Eastern Time. It's very, very sweet. Working with Candace, everybody loves her, right? Like, you're like, I'm doing a movie with somebody that, like, everybody loves. She's even better in person.
Oh, I'd
She's
love to hear
so
that.
fun and funny and smiling, and she's wearing like 17 different hats on these movies and getting stuff done, and also being, an amazing actress and kind of guiding this film and visualizing it and insisting on certain parts of the movie being part of the production that are going to make it a little more expensive, but are going to make it like the best film
She
that it can
knows.
be. And she really, really cares about that. And that moves you. So that inspires you as somebody that's working with her to come in and be prepared and bring your best. And she's very, very easy. In these movies, you may have noticed there's usually a little love story where people are falling for each other. And she's so easy to fall for, as a character. She's just because she's so authentic and she's a good, good person. She's very religious and very faithful. But that doesn't necessarily, like, sometimes that doesn't really translate in the ways that sometimes people think. It does with her, and she's just a good, virtuous person with lots of love, lots of compassion for people, lots of kindness, lots of generosity,
Well, you both
all.
seem that way, though, so I'm sure that's just the perfect match for this. Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's nice of you to say. I definitely strive for those inner qualities, and I work at them. I really do. Like I go to the gym, and I try to go to the gym, and I get strong and whatever. I try to, but I also go inwardly, and I have a spiritual life, and I have a meditation practice, and I train and practice in those beautiful ways of thinking and trying to incorporate them into, my heart, my mind, in meditation, so that when I go through my life, they're more likely to be there. And you fall on compassion instead of like anger or distance, or you fall on equanimity or kindness. Like it just, you like steep those beautiful qualities in your mind. It becomes
Yeah.
something that I literally train and try to be more and more and more, and grow them. So that's my spiritual path, and I know that Candace does similar things through.
It's so nice to hear because when we see these characters on these romantic Christmas movies, we're like, but what are they like in real life? Are they really this awesome? And you really seem to be, and so does Candace. So that just makes me even more excited to see you guys in a Christmas movie together.
That's very, very nice. He said, it'd be funny if we were like nightmares, like off camera. You know what I
I
mean? Like,
mean,
it
I'm
would not be
sure they're
funny,
out
but
there.
that would be like the worst kind of ironic. But no, I mean, I think that's what happens, with Great American. They, Bill Abbott and everybody there, but Bill knows us so well through the decades from making so many movies. And obviously, I was on Home and Family for him for many years, a talk show. And I think he knows sort of his people and their true essence, and that they walk the walk. And I don't know, I make that up. I really feel that. And so, we all just really get along. It seems like we all are similar people in that way. Just try to be good humans out there. Just try to
But that's what
spread
attracts us.
positivity. Say
You
again.
know, that's what attracts us to these movies. Because, yes, there's a million Christmas movies out there with similar storylines, but I think it's the casting that Great American has found that has really made it appeal to us as the audience.
Well, thank you. Yeah, I mean, I hope that there's truth to that, and that's all Bill and his whole team at Great American. And
Well, it's you guys too. It's you guys too. I mean,
yeah, well,
you.
I think everybody that I can't think of anybody that I don't feel super close to at Great American that really tries to walk the walk. So I'm grateful to be there. Like, it really is a beautiful family to be part of, and I'm just trying to spread positivity and bring goodness into the world, and
Well,
that's
you
what it's
do.
all about.
You do. And I'm so glad to see it in person now, November 22nd, UBS Arena. I can't wait to meet you and Candace and see the whole setup. I got outfits planning. I'm very excited about this, Cameron.
Like Christmas outfits, like you're gonna have like
Oh yeah, I
conniving
go to the
planning.
nine. I mean, I wish you could see the rest of our studio here because we actually set it up as a big gingerbread house. So when you walk inside, it's our holiday home. We built a fireplace in here just for it. Like we go all out, so the outfits have to represent. I mean, yes, I saw your setup. I'm like, I'm in a movie already. I love this.
This is my little Christmas corner. This is actually my bedroom.
Is it really? It's
Yeah.
gorgeous. Oh my
I'm not gonna
gosh.
show you the rest of it because the bed's not made, and
It's
but that corner right here,
There's gotta
this
be
like
some
frame,
realness there.
this is perfect right in here. This is all you guys get.
But that's what we have. We have a mess in our corner too with all the lights that we can't
Yeah,
untangle right now. So
exactly.
I might need to get one of those backpacks that you have, Cameron.
Oh man, you should see me up there. I gotta say,
That's
it's
a movie in the making right there. I mean.
for Great American Family, we had our little series. I had this little digital series online called The Happy Life of Cam. And we were doing all these things that make us happy. Like I was in my little series, and everybody had their own little kind of addition. And one of my episodes was doing that tree. And I
That's awesome.
remember like them going, that's dangerous. Like, I'm not sure we can air that, because I'm being a little bit of a adventure guy. I mean, I'm anyway, maybe I'll document it again this year and put something up so I can get everybody nervous.
But that's what, t like right now on TikTok, when you scroll through, that's what people are doing, all these like extreme decorating things. And then
Oh,
people m
really?
may or may not be copying it, but they take inspiration from it. So you never know what kind of inspiration.
Well, if they're taking inspiration from me doing my big outer tree, I don't want you to take the inspiration that you personally need to climb it like I do. That's for sure. It's a very, very easy tree to climb. Like, it's very easy, but most trees aren't. So please
Yeah.
don't. Please just get somebody to do it professionally, or, get a ladder, or I don't know what.
He's a trained Christmas movie professional. Let's
That's right.
not forget.
That's right. Please don't try this at home. Okay. Thank you.
Cameron Mathison, you are an absolute pleasure to talk to, and I cannot wait to see you at the Great American Christmas
You too.
Festival, November
You too.
22nd. Thank you for chatting with me.
Yeah, thank you for having me. It's good. It's going to be great to meet you finally in person, but nice to see you here. So, see you soon.
Thank you. And thank you for being an inspiration all these years. Seriously, it means so much to
Well,
me.
that means a lot to me.